Hola, mis amores. So, hello again. I'm Kara here. I was wondering why I've been feeling the urge to go live so often lately. And Abba just revealed to me because you're back fully doing what you were doing before. I've been in preparation. I've been being pruned. I've been preparing for my new role, right? And we are in the midst of the first rapture. So this rapture is not a physical one, it's a spiritual one. It is an energetic rapture. What we are in the midst of. So bright. Sorry, y'all. I'm trying to work with the lighting. It's like too bright. Perfecto. Okay, actually it's a little too dark. Okay, whatever. Can't be a perfectionist right now. This involves basically everything that you rank in the spirit is being materialized. So, we're still gonna get our God bodies and so on and so forth, but that's not the first step. The first step is the return to order of the correct order of the correct hierarchy. Now it's time for the kingdom children to be in rulership, to be in the limelight, to be in their positions of power, to be in positions of influence, to be the status quo, to be the influencers, the idols, if you will, because some people still won't get it. They'll still be idolizing other beings, instead of recognizing their mirror to the Most High. Which is what we all should be idolizing after. But, this is what we're gonna see first. We're gonna see, all these famous people losing their wealth. It's already happened to Kanye, even though technically they still have to pay him. But, still, even though he is one of the ones speaking out. Everything happens for a reason, and you're seeing a lot of these demonic marriages ending. You're seeing a lot of people dying, because they're being stripped of their titles, they're being stripped of their ill-gotten riches and ill-gotten power. And, what you're about to see is those who were always supposed to be in those positions. Now come into those positions, and the people who were in those positions will have to answer to the rightful people in those positions. Hope you understand what I'm saying. I'm speaking plainly, but I'm still not saying verbatim, right? There's gotta be a new Kim Kardashian, it girl. There's gotta be a new Beyonce and Jay-Z, and there's gotta be a new, everything, every position of power, of influence. I mean, you don't even have to be the same professions that these people are, but have the same level of influence, have the same amount of wealth, or probably way more than that because theirs is not even the real wealth, but have the same amount of influence so that it will be pointed towards the right direction. It'll be pointed back towards the creator, which is the whole point the whole point. Like, God gives us these gifts, these talents, so that we could use them to glorify the kingdom, right? But people, they squander them because they're using them for their own praise. They're using them for their own glorification, their own, satisfaction and need of approval and need for attention. And like, we still have flesh. We still will fall victim to human emotions like wanting attention, wanting validation, even if it's not something that we need. People do want this. Like, even like within your relationships, you're going to want to feel appreciated. You're going to want to feel needed at times. You want to feel like your position in someone's life or as this boss or this leader is making a difference. Like, that's how you'll know. That's the only way you'll know. So, that is what we are seeing, and we'll see a lot more of. This is the first rapture. And the second rapture is kind of spiritual too, but in like a completely different way of like the physical of the spiritual. That's probably when we get our new bodies. Oh, okay. I just got a yes. So yeah, first rapture, change of power. Second rapture, change of avatar. So all right. But who knows how long that's gonna be? So you're gonna be seeing the revelation of all the key players in the kingdom. You're gonna be knowing who's who and what's what and who the top dogs are and what their positions are and so on and so forth. So now you're really gonna see what people's rank have always been in the spiritual realm based on what their rank is about to be in the physical realm. There will be no question. Like, people can say, like, there's been so many people who claim to be one thing. Oh, I'm an ascended master. Oh, I'm this person. Oh, I do this. Oh, I'm so powerful. Blah, 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 blah. Those who still rely on sorcery and witchcraft instead of spiritual gifts. Because if you have to use a tarot card, a crystal ball, whatever that thing is called, I forget it, even though I used to use it because it's like not even need me anymore. That's a whole past life now at this point. If you have to use any conduit outside of your own physical vessel in order to communicate with the divine, that is not the divine that you are communicating with. Because God don't need no tarot cards. God don't need no crystals. God don't need no divination. No, that's why sorcerers have to resort to that, because they don't have connection to Elyon. They have to rely on familiar spirits to communicate based on patterns. They don't really know the future. They follow patterns, just like the enemy. The enemy doesn't really know the future either. He's very cunning. He, she, it, whatever. It's an entity, so it's not neither female nor male. But it's not because the enemy knows the future. It's because the enemy has a brain that it can think ahead based on what patterns that you usually act in. That's why anytime the enemy tempts you is based on what you used to like. It's based on what you used to love. But if you become a new being, those tactics don't work anymore. So the enemy has to relearn you. That's why it's good to always be evolving, because the enemy has to always keep relearning you and can't slip you up, because it doesn't know what your vices are. It doesn't know how to come at you because it doesn't know you anymore. And make sure the enemy don't know you. That's your best power play through this whole situation. That's your best power play. And I'm not trying to step on, actually, yes, I am trying to step on toes. If you're at this point in the game and you're still relying on divination and sorcery and witchcraft, you're not serving the master you think you're serving. Point blank, period. I don't care how you feel about it. This is not my personal opinion. This is fact. You can go take this straight to the boss yourself and ask for yourself with an open mind, not with for an answer that you want to hear, not for an answer to rationalize what you think it is, but for the hard truth. Because that's what I had to do when I was making thousands of dollars off of tarot readings and doing different services for people that I was very good at. Because I am a true prophet, I am a true oracle, but I was squandering my gifts because I was limiting my connection to the divine by using familiar spirits instead of only the source. And I realized that when I let go of all those things, oh my goodness, my gifts expounded in the most exponential way. Like, they got so much more powerful, it got so much more clear, there was so much more dialogue. It was like an onslaught of just my gift magnified in the most powerful way, because I was no longer dibbling and dabbling and using the stars and using astrology and all of those things. And yes, they are connected to this physical reality, but if you're not living your life based on the matrix, why would you want your life interpreted by the matrix? 1 + 1 = 2. Really think about that. And yes, God made everything. However, there's a time and a place and a reason and a season for everything. And only certain beings are supposed to be interpreting things through the stars and through astrology and all those things. And these are for specific ascended masters who are like extremely powerful beings who have clearance to work with these energies because they are pure, because they will not use them in ill-gotten ways. That's why there are reasons and seasons and rules for this. That's how most all of these people who's in the positions that they're in now, that's where they messed up. They started taking the power into their own hands. They started feeling themselves, thinking that they were so great, forgetting the fact that it's God that gave you these gifts and these abilities and the ability to discern what it is that you're seeing, and completely took God out of the equation. Like, completely. Which, again, defeats the purpose. Every gift that the Most High gives us is for the Most High's glory. The Most High's ultimate goal is when people look at their children, they see God. Not sorcerers, not familiar spirits, not the enemy, not your Auntie Sharon, not your boy Pookie, not the lady from the medium, not Ayanla Vincent. They see God. And those are just randomly names that came to my mind. I'm not saying nothing about these people. Caputo. Teresa Caputo. Long Island medium. But the point is to see God. Not anybody else. Not even you. When people look at you, they're not supposed to see you. When people look at Omkara, they're not supposed to see Omkara. They're supposed to see God. They're supposed to look at me and be like, how is this person so calm in all the situations that she's been in and can still keep going after all that she's been through? God. How can she be so loving still and so forgiving and still have open arms to people who have done her the dirtiest? God. How can she still pray for people who abused her profusely and still love them and still want salvation for them? God. That's the whole point. That's the only point. That is the only point. Yes, the only point. So, I have been in hiding for a long time, and I feel like I just got out of prison. Even though it wasn't like, it was like, if it was prison, it was like white collar crime. Federal prison, to where I'm like playing tennis and eating brunch and stuff. You know what I'm saying? Like, it wasn't like a Guantanamo Bay, Alcatraz type of prison. It was just like being on house arrest, basically. But I've had everything I've needed. I definitely know how to keep myself entertained, how to keep myself busy. I've been working on a lot of music lately because I've been feeling inspired. I love to write. I love to do my music. That's what brings me joy. I've been really working on my homeopathy line. I already know that's going to come out soon because God keeps putting it on my heart. And that is something that I've been told is going to be one of my contributions to society and one of the ways that I attract monetary, abundance. So, yeah. I don't know. I kind of just wanted to touch bases with y'all to be like, do you see your rapture in your life? Do you see it happening? Do you see the abundance in your gifts? Do you see the increase? The increase. 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 What does that mean? I know I didn't say it for no reason. Do you see the increase in your gifts and your awareness and your abilities and your you do good. That means you're on the right track. My gifts, not yet. Everything in due time. Hashem's only gonna give us what we can handle. Like I always was praying, like, oh, can you please increase my gifts? I want my gifts. I want to be able to do this. I want to be able to do that because, like, Hashem Ben told me what my gifts will be and are and what I'm capable of. And I've dibbled and dabbled into a couple of things, like, to where I could do it, but I couldn't control it. Like, there's been a couple times over the years where I've been able to read people's thoughts. So I know that telekinesis. I didn't even mean to say telekinesis. I meant telepathy. Okay, well, there you go. They are expanding though, and I'm learning so much about who I am. It's scary. Yeah, it is a little scary because it overwhelms you because you realize you're even more powerful than you let on about. You realize you're even more of a tool for the kingdom. An arsenal for the kingdom than you realized. That's the point, though. God loves the ones of us who are meek. Meek is not weak. Meek is having enough strength not to whomp your behind and give you the satisfaction of bringing me down, of destroying my energy, of disrupting my smooth current on these high seas of high frequencies. It takes a lot more power to be self-controlled than it does to pop off on somebody. But people have the illusion that if you don't rise up, if you ain't ready to fight, if you ain't ready to scrap, that you're weak or you scary. No, sweetie, you're smart. Because when you allow somebody to bring you out of character to disrupt your spirit, you invite their demons into your aura. You invite their complications into your situation. And then especially for a lot of us, we about to be celebrities, so you won't be having lawsuits if you keep whooping people because they're gonna be wanting to sue you for beating on them. Like, really think about that. You're supposed to be setting an example. Like, that's not setting an example. That's being a slave to your flesh. Just because you can fight doesn't mean you should. Save it for a time when there's a real war going on. Like, for real, I'm being honest. And a lot of people assume that I'm soft because I have so much self-control and I don't be wanting to like go there with people. But every now and then, I gotta put a little bass in my voice and step up to people and let them know, like, baby, I'm not one to play with. I am very sweet and kind and meek and honest and nurturing and all of these things, but that is not all that I am. That is what I choose to be. That's what I choose to be. Like, for real. It'd be real easy to haul off and just smack people and throat punch them and You know what I'm saying? Whatever else comes to mind. I used to love, like, a good strangle. But you can't be doing that to people. That ain't of God. That is not of God. Again, I'm talking in individual situations. If you are in war, that's war. But just one-off messy people trying to poke the bear, don't give them that satisfaction. Because they're the one that's going to win in that situation in any way, shape, or form. And it's totally not worth it. It's really not. It's really not. Is there anything else you wanted me to say? Okay, that was a really strong yes. Oh my goodness. I was talking about something and then I kind of went off on a tangent in another direction. So what did you want me to talk about? That was so funny. That was a really strong yes. Corruption? Well, what about corruption? We all know that's what this world is based on. For now. Ooh, and sorry if this is off topic, but I remember when I first met you, I resonated with your testimony and I told you I couldn't connect with my childhood. I remember that. Has that changed for you? At all? But corruption. That's what this world was based on. I recently got confirmation of SRA in my childhood. What is SRA? They can't see these comments when I post this, so they're not even going to know who I'm talking to. The old timeline was corruption. The new timeline. Oh. Alrighty. I don't even know that first word, but I can put two and two together. Satabic ritual abuse. Unfortunately, a lot of us chosen ones experience that same. It's literally witchcraft. It's not just no normal, oh, you were whooped too hard, or oh, you were yelled at, or oh, maybe you had an uncle that touched you inappropriately or used to always want hugs at the family picnic. It's always some super satanic ritual abuse. Oh, okay. Yeah. Yep. It's yep. It's always that. Because they lock us into witchcraft as children to try to lock our avatars. They still think that they can manipulate reality beyond God's plan for us. They have to understand that God allows certain things because it, again, in the end, only shows his glory. So the things that Abba has allowed, that these people think that they're getting away with, it's been for a reason. Of course they don't want you to remember. Because once you remember, the spell is broken. Once you're aware that you're under a spell, the spell is broken. Because God will only reveal it to you when you are ready to come out of it. Like, what the description of the Bible says? No one can curse who God has blessed, and no one can bless who God has cursed. The only way it worked is because you didn't know. And even sometimes when people do know, it's because they believe it. It's only working because you believe it. You can't curse what God has blessed. You can't put a curse on me. I'm blessed, baby. Do you not understand that? A lot of people don't understand that. They really think they done got so big in their britches, they think that they're more powerful than the Most High God. Just because you know how to manipulate reality, that's quantum physics, boo. That's alchemy. Anybody can manipulate reality if they know how to play the system. But to alter reality, to alter destiny? Baby, can't nobody do that but God. Yeah, they put imposters in people's family. That's the point. They have to keep an eye on you. They're called handlers. Every chosen one has... Dang. I just heard at least five. Okay. Wow. That's more than I thought. That makes sense. Both my parents, who ain't even my parents. Sorry, having a conversation with God right now, trying to make sure I say what I'm supposed to say and not say what I'm not supposed to say. Because certain stuff is personal and certain stuff is for everybody. And that's another part of being a prophet or an oracle. You have to understand that everything that God tells you was not meant to be public information. I have a voodoo high priestess as an aunt. Yeah, of course you do. I have one that's a black widow. Literally. A whole bunch of mysterious dead husbands with a lot of money. And she's an Eastern star. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's such a coinky dink. But yeah, corruption. Not over here, boo. See, the thing is, the devil still think he in charge. He, she, it, whatever. The enemy still think they in charge. And they aren't. It's just because it still looks like it. Because things are being put in place. Hashem has gone before us to put things in place so that when we come on the scene, we literally just slide in. Like, they already gonna know who we are. There's a lot of people say that. A lot of people say this, but Hashem is putting it on my heart. Like, there are people in rooms talking about you that you don't even know about you. I mean, whole board meetings of people discussing you and their involvement with you. There's other groups of people who have been waiting for you to come into their life because they know there's going to be some type of team thing, some type of brotherhood or sisterhood who's waiting to work with you that they don't know you specifically, but they know there's somebody and it's you. And they're waiting for you to do this great task that God has put on your heart and put on their heart, and they're just waiting for the final puzzle piece. That's been coming to me. Yeah. A lot of people think that they don't, like, it's either one or two things. People have been looking for something and it's right in front of their face and they don't know that they already know. Or people are like, is that it? Wow. Okay. There is no other thing. For everybody? Oh, that's funny. That's so funny. Everybody's the same situation. Okay, so this is what Abba is showing me. I have a friend. And she's in her last semester of becoming a licensed psychologist. I forget which one, but a licensed, you know, head shrinker. She's already a certified counselor, and she wanted to open like a facility for people with behavioral problems, either autistic or slight mental, I don't know what it's called now, but it's retardation. I forgot the politically correct, but y'all know what I'm talking about. Not being disrespectful. I just don't know the proper term. Or at least it escapes me at the moment. And it is interesting because she's been wanting to do this for a long time and she's tried in the past, but it just kept getting thwarted. It just wasn't her time yet. Recently, why did she find out that she's been licensed to have a facility for the last 10 years? She could have been already opened it 10 years ago. She just didn't know. She has the NPR number and everything. And it's called a National Producer Registry. Like when I was a licensed insurance broker, I had an NPR that showed that I was licensed to be able to sell insurance through whatever, sub company to provide the policies, right? I was licensed in life and health. And that number connected me through the government, through the state to say she can practice as a broker and pay her whatever commission is agreed upon with the, company that she is representing, blah, blah, blah. And it's like she didn't even know that she was already prepared for this thing and it was right in front of her. She just needed to be ready. And now all she has to do is step into it. That is the position that we are all in right now. We think, okay, well, God has been preparing us and we're finally ready now. So we're thinking, okay, so now I gotta apply for licensing or to a nonprofit, or I gotta get an investor, or like we're thinking of all these things that we need to do to get our ducks in a row. We gotta take all these leaps and bounds. We're thinking. But God has already prepared it and is already waiting for us to step into it. The things that we thought we were going to have to do to put in all this work, no, baby, we already been putting in work. Ain't no more work to put in. We have put in our work. So at this point, the work is just the work. There is no more preparation. We've been prepared. It's literally just step into it. Are you ready? This is for you. Are you going to accept it? It's already ready for you. It's already here for you. You looking everywhere around for it, and it's right here. I already got you straight. What you looking for? You don't need to do nothing to be ready. You ready, or you wouldn't, or I wouldn't have told you. If you wasn't ready, you wouldn't know about it. If God has revealed it to you, it's because you're ready. Don't matter how you think, how ready you think you are. If God has revealed it to you, it's because you are ready. It is ready for you. God has gone ahead of you to prepare a path for you. It's already done. You just have to walk into it. And I know that probably sounds a little hard to believe because it's just like, but in the regular world, you're supposed to do this and that and this and that before you can have this. Well, this is not the regular world. This is the promised land. This is New Earth. We are here on a spiritual plane. If you are in a higher dimension here and here, it will manifest here from this day forward. Maybe from this day prior, because it's already been happening for me. And it's in small ways now because God has to spoon feed us. He can't just throw us into, we got to warm up. But it doesn't mean it's not happening. Like, you're going to start to see the return, the trickle. It's going to be a trickle. It's like, think about it. Like, say you've been fasting and you haven't had solid foods in like a week or 3 days or whatever, and you just jump in and have a whole buffet. You're going to be sick. It's going to be too much for you. So it's like you have to work your way back into it. Like maybe something soft, maybe some soup, not a full 4 or 5 right out the bat. You got to take baby steps. But it doesn't mean that things aren't going to escalate very quickly because you've already been prepared, preparing. You've already been pruned. You've already separated the wheat from the tares. You've already gained all of the fruits of the spirit, self-control, chastity, like all of these things is nothing you have to work at. It's now who you are. It's your character. It's the core of your being. Zero effort. We've already done all the work. Okay. So, I don't know why I feel like I need to pick the phone up now, but look, this angle has been weird this whole video. I don't really care. It's not about how I look. It's about what I'm saying. It's about my energy. It's about who I am. If you are focused on this, even though, yes, I am a gorgeous woman, and some people stay, some people not. But it don't matter what none of y'all think because God thinks I'm beautiful. Made me just like this. Okay. And even when I didn't even like myself, God loves me. So remember that. Don't let nobody tell you that you ain't good enough for whatever it is that God said is for you. It don't matter what you look like. It don't matter how much money you got. It don't matter how tall, short, brown, white, whatever. What is for you, and don't let nobody try to trick you out of your spot. Because that's what the enemy does. He plays on your insecurities. But luckily, by this point, you shouldn't have any because God has already pruned you. I ain't talking about being arrogant. A little cockiness may not be too bad, but confidence for sure. Know who you are. Whew. Sorry, I got my boobies all out, but they there. So they gonna show a little bit. Anywho, know who you are. Know your worth. Know that you are beautiful inside and out. It don't matter what you look like. You're beautiful. You are a child of the Most High God. You are the most beautiful being that there is. And don't you ever forget it. Love y'all. Get ready. 'Cause it's time.